Welcome to the KCET NEET JEE session. In this session, we are going to study the problems on Newton's law of cooling. We know that the Newton's law of cooling states that the rate of heat loss of a body is directly proportional to the difference in the temperatures between the body and its surroundings. So, as per the statement, mathematically we can write it as dQ divided by dT, that is rate of loss, that is in minus, negative sign indicates the loss. It is directly proportional. Proportional for what? Proportional to the difference between the temperature of the body and the surrounding. So, whenever we do the calculation of this capital T, this one represents the mean temperature. So, this T represents the mean temperature of the body. Now, the same equation can be rewritten as rate of loss of heat, that is dQ divided by dT, is equal to m s dT divided by dT. Here dQ represents a small change in the heat, dT represents the change in the time, that is equal to m is the mass, s is the specific heat capacity, and dT, capital T, represents the change in the temperature, divided by small dT, that represents the change in the time. So, using these two equations, today we are going to solve the problems. Whenever we are removing this in the first equation, we have removed this proportionality and we have kept it equal. So, we have to multiply with the constant, that K is the positive constant that depends on the nature of the body. So, now we will go with the problems. Question number 1. Hot water cools from 60 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius in the first 10 minutes and to 42 degrees Celsius in the next 10 minutes. The temperatures of the surrounding is how much? So, here the surrounding temperature T naught or theta naught we have to find out. The options are 5 degrees Celsius, 10 degrees Celsius, 15 and 20 degrees Celsius. Let us go for the solution. According to Newton's law of cooling, we can write the formula as theta 1 minus theta 2, that is the change in the heat, okay, divided by T with a small change in the temperature. So, in the denominator, T is directly we have taken, that is time minus time, so final time we have written here, is equal to k into bracket of theta 1 plus theta 2 divided by 2 minus of surrounding. So, using this formula, we are going to solve this question. In the first case, initially the temperature was 60 and it came to the 50 degree. At what temperature? We do not know. The surrounding temperature is theta naught, which is in the right hand side. And to come from 60 to 50, it has taken 10 degree. To 50, it has taken 10 minutes time, which is in the denominator. In the right hand side, 60 plus 50 divided by 2, which gives the mean of the temperature of that body. So, let us assume this as the first equation. And by solving this one, we will get it. 60 minus 50, that is 10 divided by 10. 1 in the left hand side. In the right hand side, k into bracket of 55 minus theta. Then we will go with the second one. In the second case, 50 minus 42, that is from 50 to 42, the temperature is going to reduce, but again it is taking 10 minutes. So, we have k in the right hand side, which is the constant quantity. And again, 50 plus 42 divided by 2 gives the mean of the temperature minus the of surrounding. So, let us solve this one and we will take this 50 minus 42, that is 8 divided by 10 can be written as 0.8 is equal to k into bracket of 46 minus theta naught. Let us take this is equation 2. So here in the equation first, this also should be theta naught. Now by dividing equation 1 and 2, we will get it as, so 1 divided by 0.8, that means 8 divided by 10, so we can write it as 10 by 8 p is equal to right hand side, k and k cancels each other. So the equation can be rewritten as 1 divided by 0.8 is equal to 55 minus theta naught divided by 46 minus theta naught. So using this cross multiplication, we will get a relation. 46 minus theta naught is equal to 44 minus 0.8 theta naught, and the value of theta naught is equal to 10 degree. I hope you will get this answer. So the correct option is B, that is 10 degree Celsius. We'll go to the question number 2. A bucket full of hot water cools from 75 degree Celsius to 70 degree Celsius in time T1. From 70 degree Celsius to 65 degree Celsius in time T2. And from 65 degree Celsius to 60 degree Celsius in time T3. Then which of these option is correct one? Here by theory or by observing Newton's law of cooling graph itself, we can tell the answer, but even though, let us do the calculation. That is, according to Newton's law of cooling, rate of cooling is directly proportional to the mean temperature difference. So fall in temperature divided by time should be, it is directly proportional to the mean temperature and surrounding temperature. So the ratio of fall in temperature divided by time, that is rate of loss, okay, that is rate of cooling, is directly proportional to the mean temperature difference, mean temperature and the difference. So we will take this as, in the question they have given 75 to 70, 70 to 65 and 65 to 60. That means in every case there is 5 degree Celsius difference, but time we do not know how much is taking. So using this equation, I can write it as, in the first case, that is 75 plus 70 divided by 2. Okay. Similarly for second one, 70 plus 65 divided by 2. So as we take it, the comparison tells that theta 1 plus theta 2 divided by 2 is greater than theta 1 plus theta 2 divided by 2 in the second case. Similarly, if I go for the third case, this is lesser than the second case, right? So I can say theta 1 plus theta 2 divided by 2 in the third case is very least. So here, by observing this one, we can say this is greater than this one. That is, first one is greater than second one is greater than third one. That means the temperature is decreasing. Therefore, the time taken to cool from 75 to 70 degree is lesser than the time taken to cool from 70 degree Celsius to 65. And the third one is maximum, that is the time taken to cool from 65 to 60 is maximum. Let's go to the option, that is option C is the correct one. Question 3. Equal masses of two liquids are filled in two similar calorimeters. The rate of cooling will depends on what? So the direct theory question, so here answer we can say as, it depends on specific heats of liquids. Question number 4. Newton's law of cooling is used in laboratory for the determination of the. Options are like this: specific heat of the gases, the latent heat of gases, specific heat of liquids, latent heat of liquids. So obviously here the answer is option C. That answer is the specific heat of liquid. Option C is the correct one for the fourth question. Question number 5. A body cools in 7 minutes from 60 degree Celsius to 40 degree Celsius. What time does it take to to cool from 40 to 28 degrees Celsius. If the surrounding temperature is 10 degrees Celsius, assume Newton's law of cooling holds good. So, by the Newton's law of cooling, we can write the formula and we can use for the by the Newton's law of cooling, here it is 60 and 40, 40 and 28. So now using the formula, we can write for the first case, that is 60 minus 40 divided by 7 minutes is equal to K into bracket of the mean temperature 60 plus 40 by 2 minus of 10 degrees surrounding. So let us assume this is first case. Similarly, in the second case, that is the difference of temperature from 40 to 28 divided by the time, but we do not know this time how much, we have to calculate this T, and I will take it as T itself. K in the right hand side into bracket of 40 plus 28 divided by 2, that is the mean of temperature minus of the surrounding is 10. Now let us assume this as second equation. Now by solving equation 1, we will get it as, if I divide equation 1 and 2, equation 1 divided by 2 if I take, then that is 20 divided by 7 whole divided by 12 divided by t. In the right hand side, k get cancels each other, and finally we will get an equation like 20 divided by 7 into t by 12, that is equal to 10 by 6. I hope you will get it. After the solution, we will get equation as 20t divided by 84, that is equal to 10 divided by 6. I hope you will solve this one. Then finally, after the solution, the time t is equal to 14 divided by 2, that is 7 minutes. Okay, now we will see the option, that is in the option answer 7, that is option C is the correct option. Next question, question number 6. A liquid cools from 50 degrees Celsius to 45 degrees Celsius in 5 minutes and from 45 degrees Celsius to 41.5 degrees Celsius in the next 5 minutes. The temperature of the surrounding is how much? So here we have to find out theta naught. Options, we have 4 options. Let us solve the problem. By the help of Newton's law of cooling, we are writing in the left hand side 50 minus 45 divided by 5 is equal to K into bracket of 50 plus 45 divided by 2 minus of theta naught. Let us take this as equation 1. Now for the second case, we have 45 minus 41.5 divided by 5 is equal to K into bracket of 45 plus 41.5 divided by 2 minus of theta naught. Let us assume this is second equation. So again, same procedure, by taking the division or dividing equation 1 and 2, we will get it. The denominator 5 get cancelled, right hand side K get cancelled, and 50 minus 45, that is 5 divided by 45 minus 41.5, that is 3.5. So using this one, if I write left hand side, I can write it as 50 divided by 35 is equal to 95 minus 2 theta divided by 86.5 minus 2 theta. So by taking cross multiplication, we can solve it, that is theta naught is equal to 33.3 degrees Celsius. So the answer is 33.3, which is in the option D, is the correct one. Next question. The graph shown in the adjacent diagram represents the variation of temperature T of the bodies X and Y having same surface area with the time T. Due to the emission of radiation, find the correct relation between the emissivity E and absorptivity A of the two bodies. So in the graph, y-axis is representing the temperature, x-axis represents the time, and we have two different graphs for two different bodies x and y. Here let us study one by one. As the time is increasing, the temperature is decreasing. So x temperature decreasing initially very fast and later slowly. Y temperature also decreasing initially, but it is less than the x. So as the time is increasing, the decrease in the temperature is less in y case than the x case. So here I can say the emissivity of the x body is more than the emissivity of the body y. So we have another concept about black body radiation. So whenever we say the emissivity is maximum, it means the absorptivity also should be maximum. Therefore I can say in this option, the emissivity of the x, if it is greater than y, then absorptivity of x also should be greater than y. So like that we have option C. So option C is the correct one. So in the answer we can write it as E. Emissivity of x is greater than emissivity of y, and the absorptivity of x is greater than absorptivity of y. Okay, thank you students. I hope you will study some more questions in the next classes, and I hope you will practice many more problems on this base. Thank you.